first be very simple. If you want just to use single touch, you can use the mouse, because a single touch is directed to the mouse, so you can get X mouse, click, etc. So it's, see, if you want, if you don't mind. For example, all the games that we have on the iPhone, which are single touch, work without communication. I can show you some new properties. So when you are in an iPhone application, you have the screen rotation, so how the actual level is going, the actual frame is going to be rotated. So I'm going to do this clockwise, I'm going to do this counterclockwise. So if you want to make a game that's in open landscape mode, you do that. And the actual iPhone orientation, portrait or landscape. So if you want to make a game in landscape mode, you choose both. Right. In the frame, you've got a few new options. First of all, the touch mode, which could be single touch or multi-touch, knowing that multi-touch drains a lot some more battery, so if you're only using single touch, just leave it to single touch. And a joystick emulator, so you can have no touch joystick. You will see it later when I do demo. It's basically a joystick on the screen, so you put your finger and move the spoon on the screen, and it's quite easy to use. And it's automatic, you can choose fire 1, fire 2, and if it's left-handed, so it's reversed. And you've got also the accelerometer joystick, so you just move the device like this, and it will... So and this joystick works with the, like for example, the eight direction movements. So I can show you, I've got my iPod here. I can show you a simple application. So you know this one? It's the Hungry Hedgehog. It works, you can click on it. So that's about the iPhone runtime should be in the first beta should be available sometimes in August. We're very close from a release, we still have got some crashes, and I'm sure that if you test it, you will have a lot of crashes for us, which is really good to have. I forgot to say that the iPhone runtime is for iOS 4 only and Xcode 4, because I received an email from Apple saying that they will not, they will no longer accept in the shop as the application store OS 3 application. So we have to switch to 4, which is not a problem because Apple really pushes the new version of the software, and everyone is wanting to switch. Yes?
We've got one question from the chat. Does Google also notice that you've got Android runtime?
Yes, the Android runtime has been put on hold, not due to my fault, but due to a bug in the Android runtime, in the Android SDK. In order to produce an Android runtime application, I need to compile it on the fly. When you press build, just like I do with Flash, I call the Android compiler. And it crashed at the compilation time. So I dropped it, waiting for a new SDK to come out. When the iPhone runtime is complete, I will come back to the Android runtime. And also I will come back to the Java mobile runtime to add some new features.
Doesn't the new SDK came out with each new version of Android? Because we had Android 1.5.
Yes, of course. Yeah, I will switch to the latest one. Yeah, I will switch to the next
one. So I'm going to make the most new version, or also backward?
I will choose the most backward that works.
Okay.
So after I finish the iPhone, what is that?
Just after.
So that's about it. What we're going to do in the near future. Eve is going to start working on MMF3 in September. His first job will be to port the interface using a cross-platform library, so because we want MMF3 to be Mac and PC compatible. So we'll use a library called Clickteam, which is a really cool library and allow us to have the same code for both machines. Then when I finish the runtimes, sometime in December or January, I will come back with Eve. And Chris B will certainly be working with us on the Apple runtime, Apple Mac runtime. So we'll get everyone possible. Did I make a mistake? No? You should be in the front, tell me.
was it Endos?
You didn't tell him.
Oh.
So it's fine. well, that's about it. We'll be starting to work on MMF3 as soon as possible.
That's why I was wondering about this one, because it wasn't a good performance, but it wasn't so satisfied from Java runtime. As a data release only for the forums, as for everyone. Because from what you were writing, that you get a very good feedback in comparison to flash runtime, which was a small team of developers that are testing it before first version came out. How is
that your question? We.
No, because it wasn't like Java,
yeah.
Was on beta on the forums. And Flash was closer to that.
Yeah.
And we thought on the forums that you are more satisfied from the feedback from the Flash group than from Java group.
Yes, certainly we had, and we were on our side, we were more organized. We had a number of files to test. We grabbed all the files from the server that we not uploaded since 10 years, and we tested them all, so we dispatched all the files to people. So we were better organized. And we think that the closed beta is quite better. For the iPhone, we certainly won't have a closed beta because, we will have a beta with the people who have a Mac.